Welcome to another video episode on my robotic arm with robotic wrist and pneumatic hand. Pneumatic hand is controlled by this compression engine, which is my own design, but started out with the original compression engine by Physiotechniek. This compression chamber is original. Then, under this extension block is a rubber interface for most controls. These valves for the hand, this pivot which turns the base of the arm around, motor for roll of the wrist, yaw motor for the movement, the horizontal movement of the hand, and the motors for the vertical gearbox, which makes the arm go up and down like this. This motor, together with this switch, is controlled by this robot interface, and they are powered via power distributor block. Last time, after extensive testing and some modification, it turned out that although everything programmed in Python does work nicely, it's the hardware that gives a problem. And that problem is, sorry for shaking the camera, is due to the fact that this is working nicely, but the yaw winch driven by the motor is giving a problem. And the problem is that when it is pulled tight, the yaw actually can't even work. It works for a little bit and then gets stuck. So how heavy should everything be? And then main thing is that this gears, which is a cardan couple, so say one gear against another and they turn, and that is a bit weak. Should I change that? I actually should. And looking at this one, which I originally intended as such, as the same thing, I might even have to change that. So having exactly the same gear, so a warm gear and a normal gear. Would that work? The only thing I can do is try and see if that has enough power. Well, the motor will have enough power, but if the rest has enough power to actually control this. So, which is, by the way, the same way as this gear works. Also warm gear to normal gear. So let's see how that works out, because that's the only thing I know that I can take away that slipping gear. So let's see how that works out. So the first things that I need are the warm gear and the normal gear, which grips like this. And two other axles, and that brings immediately another problem with it, because right now this distance is longer, so I don't just have to replace the gears, I have to increase the distance. But first, I have to take out this. Carefully. And somehow managed to remove all of this. That's better. So this is one thing. Careful because it's still wired. So first thing to do, take off this stuff. Yeah, oops. No problem, I see where it is. Remove this one. Yeah, and then I better first remove the wiring before anything bad happens to it. It's much easier this way . Then this one goes in, the gear goes on, the worm gear. Is it as long? No, I have a much shorter one here. So I have to find a shorter one, otherwise the distance will be much further, much longer than this one. So searching for an even shorter axle. Oops. And fortunately I found two shorter axles. So this is as long as the other one. And now I realize you couldn't see the other one. So this is just as long. Only this one goes here somehow. And I still have to place the other gear. So let's see how that one works out. Not quite sure. Remove this one. And that's going to be a challenge. How to keep that imbalance. So I'm going to do that off screen. And by reconstructing, I needed here a much longer axle. The gear is in place and the supporting block should be on this side, just as here. The only problem now is that this is a rather wide, rather large gear wheel, and how will we respond? Right, it will collide here. So I need a much smaller one, which I do have, but I have to find it. Apart from that, how is this going to be working? It used to be vertical. And right here, well, that's not going to work anymore. So if it is a smaller one, how should it be? Or should it be this way? Anyway, this one has to be smaller. I'll have to figure that one out. Because the idea is nice, but the execution, that's another thing. Let's see how this works out. And after some trying, I had to come up with this solution. I know lighting isn't very good, but I hope you can see it. And I had to replace the axle once again here. to make it longer. Because, oops, this construction point block goes in here, over here actually. I had to change the direction where this wheel comes. And when I shift this construction in, it is really a tight fit. And this wheel can just turn nicely. So, how will it fit? Well, that has to be seen, but at first it seems to be the best solution. How it will run, I can connect it. See how that works out, but first of all I have to fix things, because this is rather flexible and this is rather flexible. So I have to fix those, and then, and only then, I can try to run again. But for now it seems like a nice solution. And with this very new construction, which is a very tight fit with a little bit bent axle here and bent axle here, I have to try. And of course, first I will try with the diagnostic software, because that I can control by hand. So, first taking correct interface, and I hope I'm taking the correct one. So, and yes, that looks like it. Then in the software, taking the yaw motor, that will be dual motor is motor 8, which is slave, and then number 2. Yep, that works out. But does this gear work out? It does. But as usual with warm gears, it's much slower than you expect. Now it is pulling, but pulling where? Okay, the winch doesn't do a thing, so this means that this gear isn't tight enough, and that's always the risk. And this takes a lot to adjust. Oh, the motor is still working, I see. Slowly but surely. Now it's off. But it is running, it's making contact. But if this flexibility is going to work out, that remains to be seen. So, I think, yeah, let's tighten it and then see whatever happens. Alright, and as you heard, I will show you on screen or also, so don't scroll back. So motor 8, which is in the diagnosis, slave 1, motor 4,
as you can see, could see in the previous segment. It pulls, but probably due to the flexibility of the winch, although now I see that the winch does move actually, so it is pulling, which is good. But due to the flexibility of the axle, I am not sure what the result would be. It won't slip like the previous construction. But everything remains to be seen for the final result. And I guess that's it for this test.
Alright, I tightened the gear, and we'll add, now I'm going to try it again, and that will be the last part for this. So, and it has to be the other way. And it's so flexible that the winch doesn't even move. So, I'm going to leave it at that for now. So, for now, reconstruction, but with doubtful result. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and give the video a thumbs up. Leave a comment or suggestion, very much appreciated. You can also follow me via Instagram and Wired. Instagram and Twitter, sorry. You can support me via PayPal and Wired. Very much appreciated as well. And you can also become a patron and have your name mentioned as a supporter. Much more information on my website and URL and all information are under this video. This is obviously being continued. For now, have a nice day. And bye-bye.